Saya sangat berterima kasih kepada Stikes William Putt Surabaya yang telah memberikan kesempatan emas kepada saya agar dapat mengembangkan karir dan memberikan pengalaman yang luar biasa untuk mencapai cita-cita saya menjadi perawat profesional. Semoga Stikes William Putt Surabaya semakin berkembang dalam menciptakan tenaga kesehatan yang kompeten dalam bidang.
Saya sangat berterima kasih. Kami, segenap Civitas Akademika Stikes William Putt Surabaya, siap membantu Anda mewujudkan cita-cita. Mari bergabung bersama kami di Stikes. Surabaya adalah kota terbesar kedua di Indonesia, yang merupakan pusat perdagangan, industri, dan pendidikan, yang mana mahasiswa dan mahasiswinya berasal dari seluruh pelosok tanah air. Stikes William Putt Surabaya berada di lingkar kota Surabaya, tepatnya berlokasi di Jalan Cimanuk nomor 20. Stikes William Putt Surabaya memiliki di bawah naungan Gereja Bala Keselamatan yang berperawatan, S1 keperawatan, dan profesi nurse. Selain memberikan metode pembelajaran kelas, juga memberikan waktu yang seluas-luasnya untuk berdiskusi dengan dosen sesuai bidang dan keahliannya. Upaya yang dilakukan dalam meningkatkan kompetensi lulusan, Stikes William Putt Surabaya menyediakan sarana dan prasarana, yaitu laboratorium. Antara lain, laboratorium anak, maternitas, medical bedah, gawat darurat, komunitas, dan jiwa. Sarana pendukung lain yaitu perpustakaan dengan literatur terkini dan fasilitas jurnal, baik nasional maupun internasional. Selain itu, Stikes William Putt Surabaya memiliki asrama bagi mahasiswa yang berasal dari luar kota Surabaya. Stikes William Putt Surabaya memiliki prestasi dan terus mengembangkan kerjasama nasional dan internasional, baik di bidang akademik maupun non-akademik. Stikes William Putt Surabaya menghasilkan lulusan yang berintegritas, caring, dan dijiwai semangat kasih. Lulusan tersebar di dalam dunia kerja, di berbagai pelosok dan kota, serta luar negeri.
Halo, nama saya Lia Siskan Burhani, saya biasanya dipanggil Lia, dan saya alumni Stikes William Putt Surabaya. Dan saat ini saya sudah bekerja di Seven Nursing Home Singapura. Saya tertarik menjadi perawat karena dunia perawat tidak ada matinya, dan saya memilih bergabung dengan Stikes William Putt Surabaya karena terbukti Stikes William Putt Surabaya memiliki banyak kerjasama dalam mengaplikasikan bidang keperawatan di berbagai instansi kesehatan, baik di dalam negeri maupun di luar negeri. Saya banyak mendapat pengalaman dan ilmu keperawatan dari dosen yang berkualitas dan dosen yang profesional.
Saya Tri Laksanawati, saya merupakan alumni dari Stikes William Putt Surabaya. Kami mahasiswa dan mahasiswi dipupuk sejak dini untuk selalu taat kepada Tuhan Yang Maha Esa, disiplin waktu, serta menjadi mahasiswa yang memiliki soft skill. Berkat Stikes William Putt, saya memiliki banyak pengalaman berpraktik di rumah sakit negeri maupun swasta. Menempuh pendidikan di Stikes William Putt Surabaya juga terdapat banyak kesempatan mendapatkan beasiswa. Salah satunya yaitu beasiswa ETF atau Eka Cipta Foundation. Saya menjadi salah satu penerima beasiswa tersebut. Saya sangat bersyukur, selain mendapatkan biaya tunjangan hidup dan biaya pendidikan, saya juga menerima keuntungan yang sangat luar biasa, yaitu berkesempatan bekerja di Eka Hospital. Saya sangat berterima kasih kepada Stikes William Putt Surabaya yang telah memberikan kesempatan emas kepada saya agar dapat mengembangkan karir dan memberikan pengalaman yang luar biasa untuk mencapai cita-cita saya menjadi perawat profesional. Semoga Stikes William Putt Surabaya semakin berkembang dalam menciptakan tenaga kesehatan yang kompeten dalam bidangnya.
Kami, segenap Civitas Akademika Stikes William Putt Surabaya, siap membantu Anda mewujudkan cita-cita. Mari bergabung bersama kami di Stikes William Putt Surabaya.
Okay, so we start now. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and good morning. First of all, have me to introduce myself. My name is Sandy and I'll be hosting you for today's event. Guest lecture pneumonia in COVID-19 era. And now, please let me welcome our special guest for today. Welcome to the Honorable Major Amelia Tatilang as the Salvation Army Foundation representative. Welcome to the Honorable Mrs. Aristina Halawa as President of William Booth Health Science College. And welcome to the Honorable Professor Dr. Jean Binti Ahmad as guest lecturer who will provide material on this event. And also the Honorable guests and audiences. Before we start this event, let's open it in our in prayer, which will be led by Mrs. Lina Mahayati.
Thank you, Ms. Andy. Let us pray according to our respective beliefs. Please allow me to pray according Christian tradition. We pray. Dear God, thank you for all the blessings you have given us. We are truly grateful for this day. Thank you for allowing us together in this seminar to improve and expand our knowledge. May you extend your divine wisdom to our speaker so that she will be able to impart her knowledge to all of us. May she be blessed. Bless the participant as well, so we will be able to gain valuable insight from this seminar. May you bestow your blessings upon this seminar, so that we may go out and spread your love and generosity. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Okay, thank you, Mrs. Lina. We will sing our Indonesian national anthem. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand up. Thank you very much. Have a seat, please. Ladies and gentlemen, first opening speech from William Booth Health Science College President, Mrs. Aristina Halawa. Mrs. Aristina Halawa, time is yours.
Thank you, Mrs. Sandy. The Honorable Major Amelia Tatilang as the Salvation Army Foundation representative. Professor Dr. Che'an Binti Ahmad as guest lecturer who will provide important material on this event. Lecturers and staff of Stikes William Booth Surabaya, students that I love from both institution of Stikes William Booth and from Mahsa University. Praise God, good morning, and best wishes to all of us. First of all, let us give thanks to Almighty God for His love and blessings so that we can meet online in happy and healthy. Pandemic of COVID-19 has brought us to a situation like this, and we certainly have to adapt for this condition. Today, we are grateful for having an expert guest speaker. She has a lot of experience and skillful in taking care of critical patients as a clinical from Mahsa University, namely Professor Dr. Che'an Binti Ahmad. She will share information, a topic about pneumonia in COVID-19 era. This valuable moment happens because of God's blessing in our collaboration between Stikes William Booth and Mahsa University existed. We hope for both of us to arrange another collaboration that can be developed, such as student exchange activities, clinical placement and overseas experience, or conducting joint research and community services that can be included on annual student activities. I hope that we will have a great time during this webinar until the last session. And this webinar will bring a clearly valuable sharing knowledge experience about how to deal and handling pneumonia patient in COVID-19 era, especially that happened in Malaysia, and brings a good information for all of us that we can apply it more better on our daily service to the pneumonia patient. On this occasion, I would like to appreciate and gratitude to all of committee for their efforts so this event be carried out. Thank you for all the outstanding participants or students who had attended this activity. Give their attention and participate on session discussion. And also, I am apologize if there are technical problems in the implementation of today's event. Okay, last but not the least, please enjoy this webinar. Hopefully bring valuable knowledge for all of us. Thank you, best regards, and God bless.
Thank you, Mrs. Aristina. Okay, and we also invite our moderator, Mr. Taufan Citra Darmawan. Mr. Citra Darmawan is one of the best lecturers in nursing department. He lives in Surabaya, Indonesia, and he specializes in nursing management. Okay, this is the academic qualification of Mr. Taufan. He graduated Bachelor of Nursing in Erlangga University in 2013, Nurse Program in Erlangga University 2014, and then Master of Nursing in Erlangga University 2017. He has worked as a lecturer in Surabaya Health Science College start from 2015 until 2017 and lectured in William Booth Health Science College 2018 until now. And he got some awarding from our Indonesian Ministry of Education. This is the achievement. Okay, to Mr. Taufan, time is yours.
Okay, thank you to Mrs. Sandy. Now I'm here as a moderator. My name is Taufan. I will guide the course of this session. First, I will read the speaker curriculum vitae. Okay. Her name is Dr. Cean Binti Ahmad, and her present position is Consultant in Nursing and Health, Director Nursing Professional Group, current annual practicing certificate, and current teaching permit. This is the personal data. She lives in Petaling Jaya, Selangor, and she is married and has 4 children. This is the academic qualification of Dr. Cean Ahmad. She has finished diploma nursing course from University Malaya Medical Center Kuala Lumpur. She has finished midwifery course from Rochford Hospital, Essex, England. She has finished coronary course from General Hospital Kuala Lumpur. She has finished teaching methodology course from University Malaya Kuala Lumpur. She graduated from Bachelor of Nursing Science, University Malaya Kuala Lumpur. She graduated from Master in Medical Science, Public Health, University Malaya Kuala Lumpur. She graduated from PhD in Education, Open University, Malaysia. She has many excellent awards from UMMC, start from 1997, 2002, 2003, till 2005. She has worked as staff nurse in medical surgical labor on coronary ward, and then tutor in charge of surgical and medical ward, including geriatric and gynecology ward, tutor in charge of obstetric ward, tutor in EYENENT ward, tutor in charge of ICU and CCU, head of college of nursing. She has many amazing achievements at national and international level. This is the achievement from Malaysia. And then this is the achievement from international. She has a lot of experience as a speaker, and she's been to Indonesia at 2018 in Lampung, and then 2018 in Batam, and then 2019 in Bandung as a speaker. She has a lot of research. This is the research. And then many other specialized and major contribution to nursing profession. That's the CV of the speaker today. Now, before we start, I will read the rules of this session. First, the presentation will take 1 hour, and then no interrupt during presentation. After the presentation, Q&A session will be open. Q&A will open in 30 minutes. And that's all the rule of this session. Now, the next session was a presentation by our speaker. Please welcome Dr. Cean Binti Ahmad. Time is yours.
Okay. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. And selamat sejahtera to the president, to Pak Wijaya, to dosen-dosen, to all the participants, students, lecturer from Masa University and from Sekolah Tinggi. Sekolah Tinggi Kesihatan William Booth Surabaya. Yeah. So actually I have not been to Surabaya, but I hope I'll go to your school inshallah next year. I hope so. So thank you again for inviting me to be the speaker for this webinar. And I like to congratulate for this William Booth, yeah, for organizing this webinar. I could see that Indonesia is very, very active in webinar. So congratulations to this, especially to Sekolah William Booth in Surabaya for organizing. And actually, I'm very happy. I'm Cean Binti Ahmad. Call me Cean to be the speaker for today. So how's everybody? I hope Wednesday, 2nd February, semuanya ceria and in good health. Yeah. So my topic for today, yeah, I like to thanks the moderator, Pak Taufan, for reading my CV. Thank you so much. So I'll start with my lecture, which is pneumonia in COVID-19. Actually, this COVID-19 started, as all of us know, in China at the end of 2019. And actually no one could have predicted that COVID-19 hit the world very hard in this of 2020. Everybody, most of the country, especially in Malaysia, I think our Prime Minister at that time.
Excuse me, Dr. Cean.
Yeah.
Your presentation is not yet shared.
Oh?
Yeah.
I thought I've shared already. I already put sharing. Okay. Is it?
Okay, it's done.
It's done, eh?
Yeah.
Okay, I just go back first. Okay, my topic for today is on pneumonia in COVID-19. Actually, this COVID-19, as all of us know, this is what everybody knows, that it started in China, in Wuhan, late of 2019, yeah, and then it becomes a pandemic to the world, and no one could have predicted that the world will hit the that this COVID-19 will hit the world very hard in 2020. And actually, everybody thought that 2020, from the year of this 2020, especially our Prime Minister predicted that in Malaysia, the year of 2020 will be, Malaysia will be developed. And all of us, yeah, as we know that this 2020 hit us very hard, and especially this COVID-19 has made especially the economy very bad for everybody and also the world. And COVID-19 has now spread globally with the mobility and mortality among all the population. So, you know, we especially, I did not stress so much because I'm going to speak on pneumonia. And as we know, the cause for COVID-19 is coronavirus, which is called SARS-CoV-2, which is the severe acute respiratory syndrome. Yeah. And actually, this also caused for the Middle East respiratory syndrome coronavirus, which is also similar like MERS in coronavirus. And actually, what I like to say here, coronavirus is a disease, is a new disease of 2019 and is aberrated for what you mean by COVID-19. CO stands for corona, VI for virus, D for disease. And what I like to say here, the coronavirus is a disease that causes your respiratory disease. Taufik, can you cancel the speaker, the side one, so that I can see the speaker at the side, the picture. Afwan?
Yeah, prof.
The picture at the side so that I can see my slides. The picture is ni.
What picture?
The side one here.
This slide.
Yeah. Could you just
share?
Could you just close so that I can see my slide?
Close.
Yeah, there's a slide here, picture here.
Oh,
you cannot?
Cannot. This is from Dr. Chean, not from me.
So I
full screen. I'm sorry, Professor Chean. I thought that your presentation is not yet on the full screen. You can press the F5 maybe. F5 to make the presentation full screen, like that. Okay, thank you.
Can you see? Anna?
Prof. Chean, if you want to open the new one, you can stop share first and then you open again.
Yeah. Is it a full screen?
Not yet.
Not yet.
Nah, okay. Okay, it's done.
Okay, yeah. So this is the cause of the COVID-19, which is a novel coronavirus, which is SARS of CO2, which is related to a severe acute respiratory syndrome. And it was coronavirus 2, and in the Middle East is a respiratory syndrome coronavirus, which is similar to the MERS CO coronavirus. And the coronavirus is a new virus that causes the infection to the respiratory system. And it can affect your upper respiratory tract, your sinus, your throat, and also the lower respiratory tract, and also the lung. So what is pneumonia? Since we are talking on pneumonia in coronavirus, if you can see or ring in my presentation, this coronavirus 19, a lot of research is still doing. And even the transmission, the treatment, researchers still are debate on this, how is it being transmitted, what is the disease is all about. Yeah, so if you think that after my presentation, there's a new research come out saying that this is the transmission, because people are still I'm not really 100% sure how is this, what is this coronavirus 19 all about. So I go straight to the point. What is pneumonia? As what we know is, in general, pneumonia is an infection that inflame the air sacs in one or both lung. The air sacs may fill with fluids or pus. And the causes for general pneumonia, there's two types. Is community acquired pneumonia. It can be due to bacteria, by streptococcus pneumonia, like any flu or cold. Or it can be from fungi, common in people with a weak immune system. Yeah, they inhale large dose of organism. Or it can be due to virus, which is now the COVID-19. Yeah. And number two, very common causes of pneumonia is the hospital-acquired pneumonia, which people who are on ventilator, they are resistant to antibiotic. So what is connection between COVID-19 and pneumonia? Firstly, how do you get COVID-19, pneumonia in COVID-19? Firstly, it begins when the respiratory droplet containing this virus of COVID enter the upper respiratory tract. Then it starts to multiply and progress the infection into the lung, where the pneumonia starts to develop. In COVID-19 patient, the SARS of CO2 can damage the lung and the surrounding tissue. Then the immune system starts to fight the virus and lead into inflammation that cause the fluid and the dead cell to build up in the lung. So these factors interfere with the transfer of oxygen and cause difficulty in breathing. And people with COVID-19 pneumonia can also develop acute respiratory distress syndrome, or in short, we call ARDS, a progressive respiratory failure, which occur when the air sacs in the lung is filled with fluid. Who is at high risk to get infected with this pneumonia? Definitely, people are being talking actually, older adult, 60 years old and above. But what is very important, not only an older adult, but those especially older adult who have underlying health condition, they are the worst. And also those younger age, younger than the older adult, individual with any age who have underlying health condition of serious COVID-19 illness, especially those who have pneumonia, chronic lung disease, asthma, diabetes, heart condition, liver disease, chronic kidney disease, obesity, these individuals are more prone to get COVID-19 with pneumonia. And the third category is those with weak immune system. Those who have on steroids, or any autoimmune condition, or those with cancer treatment. What are the signs and symptoms of COVID-19? Actually, I've read a lot of the research on the signs symptoms of COVID-19 or COVID-19 with pneumonia is about the same. Yeah. The signs symptoms may appear 2 days or 14 days after exposure. How is the presentation of these people with COVID-19? Usually is asymptomatic. They have no symptoms, but when they go for their screening, they are found to be COVID-19. They can also have mild symptoms or with severe illness and or mortality. Mortality is death lah. And the most common symptoms is fever, dry cough, tired, and less common symptoms, ache, pain, sore throat, diarrhea, conjunctivitis, headache, they have no smell, no taste, rash on the skin, discoloration of fingers. But those serious symptoms is difficulty in breathing, shortness of breath, chest pain, pressure on the chest, difficulty in speech or in movement. But what I like to say here, the carriers is the one that I was telling the asymptomatic, those with the signs symptoms, they are the carrier. Most patients are either asymptomatic carrier who, despite being without symptoms, have the potential to be very infectious, and they are the one who transmit to other of the close contact. Or they have mild influenza-like illness which cannot be differentiated from simple upper respiratory tract infection. So how is COVID-19 pneumonia different from the regular pneumonia? The symptoms of COVID-19 pneumonia may be similar to other viral pneumonia. Sometimes you may not know whether you have ordinary cough and cold or COVID-19 pneumonia. A study used CT scan and laboratory tests to compare the clinical of the COVID-19 pneumonia to other types of pneumonia. Researchers found that people with COVID-19 pneumonia, well, the pneumonia that affect both lung has opposed to just one. So what is COVID-19 pneumonia is that they affect the both lungs. Compared to those pneumonia that is the regular one, is usually one. And the lung characterized by a ground glass appearance via the CT scan. And the abnormalities in some laboratory tests, particularly especially assessing the liver function. And this is to show the glass that I was telling you, and this is to show this is a COVID-19 chest X-ray and how it progressed. Actually, from the A is actually they develop just small, and by you can see the progressive damage to the lung. And by the last, by the 10 days or within 14 days, both lungs are affected. And later during my presentation, I will inform that what is the effect when pneumonia effect onto the both lung, the long-term effect. So what percentage of patients with COVID-19 needs to be hospitalized? Most people, according to research, about 80% recover from the disease without needing special treatment. However, for some people, it's a serious illness. One in every 5 people who are infected with COVID-19 will have difficulty in breathing and required hospital care. But in Malaysia, once they are diagnosed in their screening with COVID-19, all of our patient is admitted to a designated hospital. What percentage of the patient with COVID-19, the signs and symptoms? Most cases of COVID-19 involve mild to moderate. And moderate pneumonia may be present in some of these individuals. And in COVID-19, the most serious, 14% of cases were the serious one, and 5% is critical. Critical means they need a ventilator. Yeah, and individuals with severe case of COVID-19 may experience a more serious case of pneumonia. And the symptoms may include trouble breathing and low oxygen level. And in critical cases, pneumonia can progress to acute respiratory distress syndrome. So when we are talking actually acute respiratory distress syndrome, so acute respiratory distress syndrome is a very life-threatening of oxygen and increase the amount of carbon dioxide.
Excuse me, Dr. Chean. Excuse me. Your signal is not stable. Maybe, yeah. Please try to speak again, Dr. Chean. Tidak ada suara ya? I'm sorry. I cannot hear your voice. Hello, Dr. Chean. Chean? I'm sorry, Dr. Chean. Your voice is cannot hear. I cannot hear. Okay, I'm sorry. This is a technical issue. Maybe for the audience, for all the audience, please wait.
Hello, can you hear me?
Hello, hello, Dr. Chean. Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay. No, I cannot hear. Hello.
Hello, yeah. I'm sorry, I can't hear your voice, but it's still unstable. Okay, Dr. Chean, maybe you can try to speak again. Yeah, I can hear you, but the signal is still unstable, so the voice not clear. Yeah. I'm sorry, I cannot hear you clearly. It's still unstable. Yeah, yeah. Okay, for all the participants, please wait a minute because this is a technical problem. So please wait it. Okay, okay, it's okay. For all the participants, don't forget to fill the presence in the chat room. The presence is already shared. So for all the participants, don't forget to fill the presence in the chat room.
Okay, try.
Hello.
Okay. Hello, Dr. Chean. Okay, it's clear.
Oh, it's clear. So I use my.
Oh, clear. This, yeah. Very clear. Yeah.
But I cannot share my.
No. Oh.
Oh. Okay. I will help you to share. So you just can present.
It's okay.
Actually, yeah. You can do that.
Oh.
You share. Then I read.
Yeah. I will share. Wait. Wait.
Okay.
I'm sorry. This is?
Yeah, yeah. No, we were not clear just now. I think down.
It's on slide 17. Slide 17.
17. Okay, this is?
17, 17.
Okay.
Oh, yes, that's it. Is it this one?
Were you? Yeah, never mind. The slide 17. On the chest X-ray. You can see the chest X-ray.
Chest X-ray. Okay. Okay, this is.
Yeah. Did you hear this? Just now when I was talking.
I can hear clearly. On this X-ray? Yeah.
No, I'm just showing this chest X-ray. This chest X-ray is just showing the sign symptoms of, I was saying that the lung looks like a ground glass, and we can see that it very progressive, the lung damage, and to the last of about the 10 days or 14 days, both lungs will be affected. So this is to show how the pneumonia, the COVID-19, we know pneumonia affects both lungs. So next slide. So what percentage of patients with COVID-19 needs to be hospitalized? Most people, about 80%, recover from this disease without need any special treatment. However, some patients need. So wait. What percentage of patients with COVID-19 sign symptoms? Don't move, Taufan. Yeah, I haven't read. Mild pneumonia present in some of the disease. 14 with severe, 5% has critical, and the 5% has critical will progress to ARDS. Next. Hello? So this is what acute respiratory distress syndrome is. Actually, in acute syndrome is a life-threatening lung injury condition that allows fluid to leak into the lung, and the breathing becomes difficult and oxygen cannot get into the body. And in this ARDS, too much fluid in the lung, which lower the amount of oxygen and increase the amount of carbon dioxide in the bloodstream. And actually, ARDS also eventually cause organ failure. Next. What is the connection between COVID-19 and pneumonia? The immune system starts to fight the virus and lead into inflammation that causes fluid and dead cells to build up in the lung. It interferes with the transfer of oxygen and cause shortness of breath. And people with COVID-19 pneumonia can develop acute respiratory distress syndrome, which is a progressive respiratory failure that occurs when the air sacs in the lung is filled up with fluids. And studies of COVID-19 pneumonia on March 20, in 2020, China has what is the connection between COVID-19 and pneumonia? So that's this is the study with COVID-19 pneumonia studies in China, 4,287. And the current cases with confirmed COVID-19 pneumonia was 1,399. So 33% of the 4,000 patients got pneumonia, of them, which is a very severe cases. And overall death rate of COVID-19 pneumonia was 4%. And most disease patients were older people with underlying disease illness. And younger cohort of 1,700 Chinese whose age was below 65 was only 0.3%. So we could see here that majority of patients with COVID-19 pneumonia would recover from the disease, especially the younger people. It shows that patients in the disease group were they are susceptible to undergo a multiple organ failure, especially heart failure and respiratory failure. So next. What is the treatment for COVID-19 with pneumonia? Next. As I informed just now in the earlier part, how can COVID-19 infection be treated? Even though with pneumonia or just COVID-19, the treatment is very supportive. And actually, research is still undergoing with the treatment for COVID-19 or with pneumonia. And how is it treated? Next. Next slide. Currently, no specific treatment. And COVID-19 pneumonia focus on supportive care. And COVID-19 pneumonia often receive oxygen therapy. And the severe cases may require the use of a ventilator. And sometimes people with viral pneumonia can have secondary bacterial infection. So because of that, antibiotic is given to treat the bacterial infection. Next. Actually, we can see here the management for COVID-19 or with pneumonia, they are given antiviral. Yeah, so we can see the antiviral drugs that has been given, but in different countries, different drugs are being given, and also they are given anti-inflammation, like steroids, and also the third one is a support. As we said just now, this COVID-19 is actually the treatment is supportive by giving nutrition, oxygen therapy, fluid control, and also more for supportive treatment. So next. So those severe cases, for especially pneumonia, may require invasive ventilation. Yeah, it's a mechanical ventilation machine which is used to force air into the lung and reduce fluid in the air sacs. So hoping that there's less damage to the lung. As we know, pneumonia can lead into ARDS, as what we've been explained before. So next. So how is it being diagnosed? Actually, for ordinary COVID-19 in Malaysia, we use two tests, rapid test kit, and also if the rapid test kit is positive, then we go to PCR, which is called polymerase chain reaction. But for COVID-19 pneumonia to diagnose, They need to diagnose if there is a pneumonia. They use chest X-ray or CT scan as part of a diagnostic process. And this can help the doctor to visualize the changes in the lung. Just now, as we showed the CT scan of those damaged lung, so the doctor may want to see to visualize changes in the lung that may be due to COVID-19 pneumonia. And laboratory tests may also be helpful in assessing the severity of the disease And this may be they have to take a complete blood count. Next. So this pneumonia, lead to ARDS has a long-term effect. Recently, I think last week, I have a friend who was admitted with COVID-19 and she got a very severe pneumonia and she was on the ventilator. She recovered the ventilator. She was off the ventilator. And actually, the doctor told her that that there's no more COVID-19 anymore. She's free from COVID-19. But just after the doctor says that she's free from COVID-19, because of the long-term effect, she passed away last week because of the lung damage. So this is to show, studies also shows that for those COVID-19, with severe pneumonia, and with ARDS, lung damage to COVID-19 may lead to a lasting health effect. One study found that 66 out of 70 people who had COVID-19 pneumonia still had lung lesion visible by CT scan when they left the hospital. And like my friend that I told you the story, And she also has breathing difficulty may continue during and after recovery due to a lung damage. And if severe pneumonia or ARDS, they may have a lasting lung scarring. And interstitial lung disease and pulmonary vascular disease are likely to be the most important respiratory complication. And this is what people are frightened of COVID-19 because of the long-term effect. Next. And the long-term effect also, the other side effect may include muscle weakness, fatigue, impact quality of life, and compromise the mental health. Because of they cannot do what they are before the COVID-19. And the treatment guideline under the WHO, whoever wants to see what is the clinical management of severe acute respiratory infection, WHO, 13 March of 2020, has come out with this guideline. And now we have seen, ladies and gentlemen, regarding the signs, symptoms, the treatment, so how is this actually COVID-19 with pneumonia being transmitted? COVID-19 transmission route. Next. Tafan, next. Is on the mode of transmission. The treatment guidelines, as I told you, is actually the WHO has come up with the clinical management of severe acute respiratory infection that you can look into the 13 March by the WHO. Next. Ladies and gentlemen, we can see just now, we have covered actually what is the disease, what are the signs, symptoms, what are the treatment, how do really this COVID-19 affect the damage that they have caused into the lung of the individual. So actually, how is it actually being transmitted? Because once you know how is it being transmitted, then you can prevent this COVID-19 with pneumonia. A lot of research have stated and still the transmission people are still arguing on how is this transmitted. But what we are very clear how it's being transmitted is actually through droplets. You can see droplets, direct contact, and indirect contact. So direct contact, for example, you shake hands. Droplets is when you cough, you sneeze, and indirect is actually when you touch any surface. Yeah. So knowing the transmission, next. So when you know the transmission, then you can prevent the chain of transmission. So next. So in prevention for COVID-19, frequent hand wash, social distancing, avoid crowded area, wear mask, cover your nose, mouth, yeah, stay at home if you're not well, seek help if you got fever, cough, and you have to sanitize the area, yeah, that you touch frequently. Next. So this diagram shows a very good how you want to break the chain of infection. You need to know the organism, as what we know is the COVID-19. Yeah, how is it this COVID-19? What is the reservoir? Yeah, is the respiratory tract. So you need to know what is the exit portal. Yeah, through sneezing, all this talking. Yeah, and then how is it being transmitted? As what we know, droplets. Yeah, direct and indirect contact. How it enters the human body, and how they get into the new host. So by knowing this break the chain of infection, then next slide. What I'm trying to say here, you must do hand washing, which is very important and effective and proper hand washing. This in Malaysia, we call a 7-step of hand washing. Social distancing is very important. Yeah. Not near to each other. Next. Avoid touching your eyes, nose, and mouth. Yeah. Avoid 3 C's. In Malaysia, we call that crowded places, close contact setting, confined and enclosed space. So this is the most important, that if we want to break the chain of this disease, COVID-19. Next. Wear mask, which is very important. Here in Malaysia, if you don't wear all this prevention, wear mask, you are being fined. And also in Malaysia, just that if you go anywhere before you enter, you are supposed to scan, yeah, so that this is, if there is cases, which is a new case, which is into that area, then they inform who is the contact person. So this is how in Malaysia, we want to break the chain of disease. And also to break the chain of transmission, no hugging, no shaking of hands. Next. So we should avoid shaking hands. Yeah, no more. I think nowadays I could see that people are not shaking hands. They just greet by nodding. Yeah, next. Also now, a lot of, I think in the world also, they encourage to go cashless to reduce the contact. So e-wallet, vending machines, all this lah, to protect yourself and others. Next slide. This is, I show this slide, this is the contactless innovation. by the world, how there's no contact. Yeah, for example, if you want to donate, it's also contactless. You want to go to supermarket, also there's no contact. If you go for exercise, and then now I think in the world also there's a lot of food delivery, and then there's also contactless protection, yeah, by a lot of ways. So by e-wallet. So this is some of the means that to prevent this COVID-19 with pneumonia. So next. So my conclusion, yeah, we have known that this COVID-19 with pneumonia, what is it that this pneumonia can have a lasting effect on the lungs, and it can cause death. As we know, now the death rate from COVID-19, it keep increasing. Therefore, what is important is we have to defeat COVID-19 pneumonia. It's a worldwide effort and is a responsibility of every individual, is a responsibility of every country, and is a responsibility of the world, yeah, to keep, yeah, because what is next slide? What is important, what the message that I like to tell you all before I finish is stay safe. Yeah, please make sure yourself is safe, your family, your community. So knowing about COVID-19, how dangerous or serious about this COVID-19. But what I want to say here and stress, do not be too frightened of the disease. If, for example, you followed how to prevent COVID-19, yeah, I'm sure we can, the disease or can be reduced, yeah, and can be prevented from getting to us, to the community, yeah, and to everybody. The most important is the transmission. We have to break the transmission and protect each other. So as what we say here, look after yourself. The greatest wealth you will ever possess is your health. So that's all. Thank you for listening. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you so much for Dr. Cean Binti Ahmad. Yeah. We have got a lot of knowledge from the presentation, yeah. And now, Dr. Cean, we will open a Q&A session. The Q&A will divide it into two sessions. The first session is 3 questions, and then the second session is 3 questions. So, for all the participants who want to ask, please use the raise hand feature in Zoom, or maybe you can ask by using chat feature, and then I will read it. Okay, maybe any question, please raise your hand using a feature in Zoom. Any question? Okay. The first question maybe from chat room. This is from Veronica Laura. The first question is that true? If pneumonia vaccine can protect us from COVID-19? That is the first question. Is that true? If pneumonia vaccine can protect us from COVID-19. Okay. And then I will read the second question from Mr. Justino. Okay. Mr. Justino have 2 questions. The first question is, how about spreading COVID in, what's it? in gastritic and colon, is there can spread? And then the second question is, how about student room in your country? Hello, Dr. Chean, my clear is for is my voice is clear. I'm sorry.
One.
Yeah.
Whether pneumonia vaccine can can prevent from getting COVID-19 lah. Okay.
Yeah, that is the first question.
Now there's a lot of people talking on the vaccines. This COVID-19 could reduce in the world. So whether is 100% any vaccine, they cannot promise you 100% you being protected. Hello?
Hello, Dr. Chean. Yeah, I can hear
yeah,
you.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. No vaccine can promise 100%. Yeah. As you said, from the nowadays, the COVID-19, yeah, some says 95% protection. Yeah, it's not 100%. Yeah, if you take a vaccine, what is important is you still have to build your immunity. You cannot depend totally on the vaccine to prevent from getting this COVID-19. That is the answer.
Okay.
Yeah. But definitely, you. Certain percentage is there to protect the disease lah. Yeah, from getting the disease, the okay, vaccine.
Okay. So okay. It divided on our immune, yeah, not only yeah. Vaccine, yeah. Okay. For a second choice, the. For a second question, Dr. Chean.
Yeah.
How about room design in a student in classroom? You know, to make it safety for spreading COVID in the classroom. Is there any specific design okay. or maybe characteristic in your country?
Okay. Just to say is most majority of the university of the colleges and even the school now yeah is actually work from home and actually online classes. However we do yeah have some places have also one or two classes if they cannot stop the classes. If, for example, they have classes, it must be in a small group, not in a big group. And the social distancing, yeah? And, for example, the prevention, yeah? As I told you just now, the how is to prevent the transmission must be followed. So in Malaysia, before you enter, yeah, definitely you have to wear mask. You're being scanned for your temperature and you have to sanitize or wash your hands. And the classroom, they arrange into a far, about 1 meter away from each other. Yes, but here, majority at the present, is online classes. Yeah?
Okay.
Okay, next question. Okay. Yeah.
The next question is still from Mr. Justino, it's about spreading from digestive tract. Is there can spread it?
Okay. I've read a lot of these things, and I think I saw in the TV recently, if you said about digestive is, I think what you meant is food lah, isn't? There's a lot of, I read this, whether food can be, one of the transmission is through food. I'm not saying 100%, because before I start just now, still there's a lot of research is still doing on how this disease, since this COVID-19 is a very new virus. Before this, people doesn't know. So a lot of research. At the present moment, now, people are still, even the world, WHO, I read, they said food is not one of the way of transmission. But you can see in China, they found frozen food, COVID-19 virus is there. So I'm not, that's why I said this is not a, people are still doing a lot of research on it. Recently, people need. So, but if you read any, at the present moment, they say it's not, food is not one of the ways of transmission of COVID-19. Okay?
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Chean. And then this is the last question for session one. From Anggi Trisna. Asks, usually patients with pneumonia case have a small cure rate. With additional pneumonia case related to COVID-19, can they recover? Because most of the case, like the patient, dies.
Yeah. Okay. As I think I've already explained just now, in the signs and symptoms, those mild cases to moderate, they survive. Usually, even sometimes, I have a friend who was admitted with severe pneumonia and was on ventilator. He survived. But remember, I was telling you, those pneumonia that affect that the lung damage, they have a long-term effect on the lung, on their performance of the functioning of the lung. Which they can cause death. So therefore, we can see a lot of death due to COVID-19 is those with those severe pneumonia, which on respirator, and they did not recover. They have a lung damage there. So they died from the ARDS lah. From the lung damage. But so those with mild cases of pneumonia, they recover. But those with severe critical, this is the mortality, the death from the patient with COVID-19.
Okay, thank you to Dr. Chean. And then now, in session two, we have three questions. The first question, maybe from our student, from Vivi Dwi Fatmala. Vivi, can you ask the question?
Thank you, sir. Hello, my name is Vivi Dwi Fatmala. Currently, I study a diploma program in nursing at Stikes Wilianpur, Surabaya. First of all, I would like to express my sincere appreciation to Dr. C.N. Binti Ahmad for the lecture about pneumonia in COVID-19 and allowed me to ask questions. Previously, I apologize first if the my question submit will open some parties. So the point from my question is first, how does the medical team convince people who do not believe that COVID is a real thing Even though the medical team has provided evidence in the form of lab results, because some of our people think that COVID-19 is a game by the government and the hospital to reap the benefit of this booming problem. This is because the community concludes that family or friend or neighbor who have been used to the hospital, such as dizziness or toothache or common fever, are confirmed to the positive for COVID-19 by the hospital. And my second question is, how does COVID-19 more deadly in people with obesity? What are the correlation between them? Thank you.
Okay, okay. Thank you, Vivi.
Vivi, thank you so much for the question. The first question was clear. Second question later I will ask you. The first question you asked, I think same thing like in Malaysia, people who do not believe, yeah, of this COVID-19, they think that the government is making propaganda or something like that. So what is very important, you cannot scold people or whatever, but what is important here is the social media, yeah? The social media plays a very important of this to tell the people about the disease of COVID-19. Yeah. So the constant on the social media, and also I feel that the government representative, for example, like in Malaysia, the director of health, yeah, place important where they have a briefing daily, every day, the same time. They will tell regarding the progress of the disease, what they have done, so that people are confident. Yeah, and this is true, because a lot of people still do not believe. I can see that in Indonesia, yeah, in Indonesia, I see that people also, my friends are telling lah, yeah, that people are not practicing, yeah, the cases, not practicing the how to prevent, wear masks or wash hands, because they do not believe that this COVID-19 is there, yeah. So to me, is the answer is social media plays very important. Number one is the representative of the government must be actually every day, yeah, constantly telling to the community, to the public regarding this disease and how serious is COVID-19. Yeah, that is the need. But your second question, well, is not clear lah.
The second. Maybe I can tell you about the second question from Vivi. Yeah. The second question is how does COVID more deadly in people with obesity? Oh. What are the correlation between obesity and deadly in COVID?
Okay. Vivi, what does connection with obesity and COVID-19 with pneumonia? As what you know, when we are obese, yeah, our immune system are down. We are, our immunity, we are not healthy. There's a lot of problems. And obesity is related to other conditions also. It does not only with obesity. So that's why how we get all these diseases, not only COVID-19 or others, other disease, is you're weakened. That's why I said who's at risk is the immunity. Now is actually we must build back our immunity, everybody, yeah, of immunity. So one of the ways to build up is actually exercise, yeah, by exercise, good mental health, and also you reduce your weight, yeah. And I hope that with this I see I read also in some of those papers with people staying at home, people eat, and people can put on weight. So do be careful, yeah, that we are not eating too much, even though we stay at home with inactive. We must be active so that our immune system is improved further. Okay?
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Chean. The yeah. second person question is from Sarmaulina Simorangkir. Sarmaulina? Hello, Sarmaulina?
Ya, halo Pak. Bisa dengar suara saya nggak?
Okay. Can you ask the question?
All right. First of all, I want to introduce myself. My name is Okta. I'm a nursing student and I'm on my fifth grade. I have a question. You said on your presentation, there is a difference between pneumonia, COVID-19 and usual pneumonia, right? And the question is, what's more danger between COVID-19 pneumonia than usual pneumonia? Because 80% will recover without any special treatment and 4% died by pneumonia, and mostly they have Lyme disease. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Just now during the sign symptoms, what is the difference of those with whether there's any difference within those with COVID-19 with pneumonia and without? What I'm saying is actually the sign symptoms, those with ordinary COVID-19 and or ordinary pneumonia, they are actually quite similar, the sign and symptoms. But only the only problem with COVID-19 with pneumonia is the lung. Usually they are very severe with COVID-19. My slide, which is number how is COVID-19 pneumonia different from ordinary pneumonia? The symptoms of COVID-19 pneumonia may be similar to other types of viral pneumonia. They are similar to other types. There's not much different. Only there's three things here. With COVID-19 pneumonia, number one, pneumonia with COVID-19 affect both lungs. Number two, the characteristic is they look like ground glass appearance via CT scan. And those pneumonia with COVID-19, when they take the blood test, they also involve the liver function is also, there's an abnormal there. So what I'm trying to say here from my slides, I'm opening now, symptoms with COVID-19 may be similar to any other viral pneumonia. Only there's three things which is different from COVID-19 pneumonia. There's three things. Yeah, I will share, I think they will share with you the slides with you. Okay?
Okay. Dr. Chean.
Yeah.
Maybe Sarmoina have some asking or question.
Yeah. Yeah.
We have another question, not the different, I say most dangerous.
The most dangerous.
Yeah.
Or most dangerous.
Yeah, yeah, between COVID or pneumonia.
Yeah. Okay. Because as what we say just now, COVID-19 pneumonia, they can progress further into acute respiratory distress syndrome. Yeah. Most of those with COVID-19 pneumonia, that's where the death occurs. That's why the mortality from COVID-19 pneumonia caused a lot of death because of ARDS. Yeah. So that is COVID-19 pneumonia lah. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Thank
and
you.
And then okay. The third person is from Muhammad Farid Ismail.
Yeah.
He is from Mahsa University, diploma student. He asks, the question is, until now, is there any specific treatment regarding this COVID-19?
Okay. Good question. Everybody wants treatment and to solve this problem of COVID-19. Why is it that you can see that this COVID-19, the cases is getting more and more and more, worldwide? Is because there's no specific treatment for COVID-19. It's more to supportive treatment, as I showed in the diagram just now in my slides. So supportive. If, for example, I know the only way, people are still talking and still debatable, people said is the only way is vaccine. So that's why now everybody is rushing to get the vaccine. But even that vaccine also, people now are still arguing about whether should we. I also myself are now questioning if the vaccine comes, whether should I have the vaccine or not. So it's all questionable. It's up to everybody, whether we want the vaccine or not. But however, that your question is whether there is a treatment for COVID-19 is more so supportive treatment. Okay?
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Chean. And then this is the last question
for
this Q&A. And then the last question is, how do we prevent mental disorder due to COVID-19?
Yeah. Okay. How? There's a lot of studies shows that with this COVID-19, even in Malaysia, people have, mental, for example, more to stress, anxiety. I presented also one talk on this, how does it affects on the mental health. But to me, how to prevent it is the individual, the individual and the family. Number one, I think people, as I said just now, do not be too scared lah. To me, is this is from God, this is from Allah, the disease comes, and is how for us to prevent, to prevent this transmission, break the transmission. Number two is, do not, they are too scared, some of them, until they stay at home, there's no activity at home, there must be some kinds of activity to go into a good mental health. So for me, it's actually exercise, walking, which develop into a good mental health. Knowing about the disease, how to prevent also, is also very good. This is one way of good mental health. And I think in this COVID-19, what is the blessing is you are near to God. Pray. To whatever God that you believe in. And I think this is the, to me, is from my experience, this is the best way to have a good mental health lah. Besides physical, you're doing physical activity, mental health, to prevent from this disease.
Okay, thank you Dr. Chean Binti Ahmad for all the answer. And then this is the Q&A session. And we have got a lot of knowledge from the presentation that have been presented by Dr. Chean Binti Ahmad. Thank you, Dr. Chean Binti Ahmad. And now I will turn over this event to Mrs. Sandy Fitza. Thank you for all.
Thank you, Taufan.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mr. Taufan, and also for Professor Dr. Cheang Binti Ahmad. Okay, now we will listen the resume for this event led by Mrs. Martha.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Sandy Fitza. Thank you for Professor Cheang for very interesting presentation topic. And I will try to conclusion our event. Okay. It's a great abbreviation of Corona is from COVID. COVID is CO is for Corona and VI for virus and D for disease. And as we know, COVID-19 has now spread globally with increasing morbidity and mortality among all population. Pneumonia is an infection that inflames air sacs in one of both lungs. The air sacs may fill with food or pus. And the connection between COVID and pneumonia, first, it begins when respiratory droplets containing enter the upper respiratory tracts, then it starts to multiply and progress the infection in the lung where pneumonia starts to develop. And in COVID-19 patient, the start can damage the alveoli and surrounding tissue. Next, the immune system starts to fight the virus and lead into inflammation that cause food and dead cells to build up in the lungs. So this is the main cause with the transfer of oxygen and cause shortness of breath. And people with COVID-19 pneumonia has a progressive respiratory failure that occurs when the air sacs in the lungs fill up with the fluid. And the most people that risk for developing COVID-19 pneumonia is an older adult, 65 years old and above, and who that have underlying health condition like diabetes, heart condition, liver disease, chronic kidney disease, and obesity. And people who have a weakened immune system also, like a cancer or other autoimmune disease. And then the signs symptoms of COVID-19, the most common were fever, dry cough, and tiredness. And for the serious symptoms, we'll get difficulty breathing or shortness of breath, chest pain or pressure, loss of speech or movement. And how is COVID-19 pneumonia different from regular pneumonia? Is pneumonia that affect both lung as opposed to just one, and lung that had a characteristic ground glass appearance with CT scan, abnormality in some laboratory tests, and particularly does assessing liver function. And for the acute respiratory distress syndromes, there were too much fluid in your lungs can lower the amount of oxygen or increase the amount of carbon dioxide in your bloodstream. And people with COVID-19 can also develop acute respiratory distress syndrome or ARDS, a progressive respiratory failure that occurs when the air sacs in the lung fill up with the fluid. And as we know together, how we can prevent the COVID-19 is with frequently hand washing, maintain a safe distance, avoid crowded area, wear your mask, and cover your nose and mouth with your band and stay at home and seek medical attention if you have fever, cough, and difficulty breathing, and sanitize commonly touched areas frequently. Okay, I believe that together we can face this pandemic, government, social media, and community. But the key, the most important thing is the key or the vaccine to this COVID-19 is our discipline. Have to build our immunity to protect us to get COVID-19 disease. With discipline, we believe that we can face it together. We must be very active also to increase our immune system. Thank you very much. That's all my conclusion. Thank you, Prof. Jaan.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Mrs. Mark, for the conclusion. Now we will give the symbolist certificate of appreciation to our guest speaker. Maybe Mrs. Erika Untari Dewi can take the part.
Okay, thank you, Miss Andy. Good morning, Professor Chan.
Good morning.
Thank you very much for acknowledging us. Please ask us to confirm the highest appreciation for the Professor Chan in the Ahmad by delivering the results for some certificate to the infant body. Give applause to Professor Chan. The certificate, Prof. I'm sorry. Can see? Okay.
Thank you. Yes. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Yes. Thank you very much for this.
See you then. Yes. See you next time in Surabaya and in Malaysia.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Mrs. Erika. Now maybe we will take some picture. Please, everyone, turn on the camera. Please, the host or co-host, take this part. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Okay, next. 1, 2, 3. Okay, next. 1, 2, 3. Okay, maybe the last slide, yeah. 1, 2, 3. Okay, thank you very much. I remind you all to fill the evaluation link.
Thank you, Andy. Bye.
Okay, Prof, before we close this event, we would like to say thank you to the all participants who joined this event, and we apologize if during this event any some mistake outside our attention. I'm sure.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Chean. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you to all students.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Berjumpa.
Bye.
See you next time. Bye. Thank you, Prof. Bless you.
Okay. Oh, sorry, Mr. Henry.
Yes. Yes, yes. Thank you, Mrs. Sandy. Before we going to closing and finishing this event, ladies and gentlemen, let us pray. Please, permission, I will lead in a Christian way. My Lord, we say thanks for all your graces and gifts that you have bestowed upon us. Today, with full of intimacy and happiness, you present here to accompany and helping us so this guest lecture can be carried out according to our expectation. My Lord, this activity is a good event and has its important meaning for us, especially to establish a friendly relationship with Massey University, as well as to improve our competence. We hope you give us knowledge and your all wisdom so that we can taking part is providing services the best in the health sector. My Lord, with the end of this event, may you bestow strength and foster a sense of brotherhood always among us. In the name of Lord Jesus, we offer the prayer of thanks and hope. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Mr. Hendrock. We will see you in the next event. Keep healthy.
Thank you, Miss Andy.
Thank you all.
Thank you all participants.
Yeah.
Prof. Cean.
Prof. Cean sudah.
Sudah keluar.
Sudah keluar. Yeah. Thank you for all.
Don't forget to fill the evaluation.
Sudah ya, meeting ya.
Sampun Pak.
Terima kasih Bu Eni.
Surabaya adalah kota terbesar kedua di Indonesia yang merupakan pusat perdagangan, industri, dan pendidikan yang mana mahasiswa dan mahasiswinya berasal dari seluruh pelosok tanah air. Stikes Wiliambut Surabaya berada di lingkar kota Surabaya, tepatnya berlokasi di Jalan Cimanuk nomor 20. Stikes Wiliambut Surabaya memiliki sejarah perkembangan yang luar biasa. Berada di bawah naungan Gereja Bala Keselamatan yang berdiri sejak tahun 2010 dengan program studi D3 Kebidanan, D3 Keperawatan, S1 Keperawatan, dan Profesi Nurse. Selain memberikan metode pembelajaran kelas, juga memberikan waktu yang seluas-luasnya untuk berdiskusi dengan dosen sesuai bidang dan keahliannya. Upaya yang dilakukan dalam peningkatan kompetensi lulusan itu sudah menyediakan sarana dan prasarana, yaitu laboratorium. Antara lain, laboratorium anak, maternitas, medical bedah, gawat darurat, komunitas dan jiwa. Sarana pendukung lain yaitu perpustakaan dengan literatur terkini dan fasilitas jurnal baik nasional maupun internasional. Selain itu, Stikes Wiliambut Surabaya memiliki asrama bagi mahasiswa yang berasal dari luar kota Surabaya. Stikes Wiliambut Surabaya memiliki prestasi dan terus mengembangkan kerjasama nasional dan internasional, baik di bidang akademik maupun non-akademik. Stikes Wiliambut Surabaya menghasilkan lulusan yang berintegritas, caring, dan dijiwai semangat kasih. lulusan tersebar di dalam dunia kerja di berbagai pelosok dan kota serta luar negeri.
Halo, nama saya Lia Siskan Nurhani, saya biasanya dipanggil Lia dan saya alumni STIKAS Wilayah Ambon Surabaya. Dan saat ini saya sudah bekerja di Seven Nursing Home Singapura. Saya tertarik menjadi perawat karena dunia perawat tidak ada matinya dan saya memilih bergabung dengan STIKAS Wilayah Ambon Surabaya karena terbukti STIKAS Wilayah Ambon Surabaya memiliki banyak kerjasama dalam mengaplikasikan bidang keperawatan di berbagai instansi kesehatan, baik di dalam negeri maupun di luar negeri. Saya banyak mendapat pengalaman Halo. Dan ilmu keperawatan dari dosen yang berkualitas dan dosen yang profesional.
Saya Tri Laksanawati, saya merupakan alumni dari STIKAS Wilayah Ambon Surabaya. Kami mahasiswa dan mahasiswi dipupuk sejak dini untuk selalu taat kepada Tuhan Yang Maha Esa, disiplin waktu, serta menjadi mahasiswa yang memiliki soft skill. Berkat STIKAS Wilayah Ambon, saya memiliki banyak pengalaman berpraktik di rumah sakit negeri maupun swasta. Menempuh pendidikan di STIKAS Wilayah Ambon Surabaya juga terdapat banyak kesempatan mendapatkan beasiswa. Salah satunya yaitu beasiswa ITF atau Eka Cipta Foundation. Saya menjadi salah satu penerima beasiswa tersebut. Saya sangat bersyukur. Selain mendapatkan biaya tunjangan hidup dan biaya pendidikan, saya juga menerima keuntungan yang sangat luar biasa, yaitu berkesempatan bekerja di Eka Hospital. Saya sangat berterima kasih kepada STIKAS Wilayah Ambon Surabaya yang telah memberikan kesempatan emas kepada saya agar dapat mengembangkan karir dan memberikan pengalaman yang luar biasa untuk mencapai cita-cita saya menjadi perawat profesional. Semoga STIKAS Wilayah Ambon Surabaya semakin berkembang dalam menciptakan tenaga kesehatan yang kompeten dalam bidangnya.
Kami, segenap Civitas Akademika STIKAS Wilayah Ambon Surabaya, siap membantu Anda mewujudkan cita-cita. Mari bergabung bersama kami di STIKAS Wilayah Ambon Surabaya.